a student of management studies at GE Jodhpur. I'm here to brief about the current year union budget. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman presented the union budget 2020-2021 in the Lok Sabha. This is the second budget after Narendra Modi led NDA returned to power for a second term. This year's budget centers around three ideas: aspirational India, economic development, and a clean society. Sitharaman proposed a new tax regime. This tax regime is optional. The taxpayers can also stick to the old tax regime. In the new tax regime, 70 tax exemptions will be removed, but the income between Rs. 5 lakh and Rs. 7.5 lakh will be taxed at 10%, down from current 20%. Income of Rs. 7.5 lakh and Rs. 10 lakh will be taxed at 15%, down from current 20%. And income between Rs. 10 lakh and Rs. 12.5 lakh will be taxed at 25%, down from current 30%. And income above Rs. 15 lakh in a financial year will continue to be taxed at 30%. Budget nominal GDP growth in year 2020-2021 is estimated at 10%, and fiscal deficit for this year is seen at 3.5% of GDP. Rate of central excise duty on certain products such as cigarettes, chewing tobacco and tobacco extracts has been increased. Custom duty has been raised on some items such as tableware, kitchenware, footwear, fans and toys. Certain exemptions on facilities to current and former members of the UPSC and election commissions such as rent-free residence, conveyance allowances and medical facilities are exempt from tax. These exemptions have been removed. TDS of 1% will be levied on e-commerce transactions. Government has proposed to provide Rs. 1.7 lakh crore for transport infrastructure in 2021. And Chennai-Bengaluru Expressway and Bengaluru Suburban Rail project to be started. Government aim to achieve electrification of 27,000 km of lines.
Punam, I am Andhra Patel and here to present budget of 2021. The government has decided to sell a part of its stake in LIC through IPO. The company will now no longer required to pay dividend distribution tax. Bank deposit insurance cover has been increased from 1 lakh to 5 lakh per depositor. Government plans to amend the Companies Act to decriminalize civil offences. The government has allocated 2.83 lakh crore for agriculture and allied sectors. The government has decided to provide 30 lakh farmers to set up solar pumps. Government has allocated 69,000 crore for health sector. The government has allocated 12,300 crore for Swachh Mission Abhiyan this year. The government has allocated 99,300 crore for education and 3,000 crore for skill development. Urban local body will provide internship for 1 year to Indian engineers. Thank you.